Hey guys, what's up? It's Ashton. Sorry I'm late again. I've worked the past 5 days in a row, and again I'm exhausted. And it's Monday night, I think it's Monday. Yeah, it's Monday. I don't even know what day it is anymore. And here I am. So happy days. This week we're talking about passing tips, and apparently I still pass pretty well because I got called sir at Qdoba yesterday. And if you don't know what Qdoba is, it's like Chipotle but better because they have queso. So it's really more like Moe's if you know what Moe's is. So, passing. Let's start from the head down. Hair. Clearly, I have what some would refer to as a boy's haircut. It's growing out right now, as you can see. It's quite long in the front, and I'm actually trying to grow it out because I like it to swoop to the side, and it's starting to be able to do that, so that's cool. I am growing a rat tail in the back. I mean, I don't want a super long one down my back, but the way it looks right now is cool. It looks like this. I hope you can see it. Okay, so, yeah. It started out with me getting my hair cut, and he was like, "Do you want me to leave the peak in the back?" And I was like, "Yeah, sure, cool." So now I have a rat tail. It's pretty cool. I like playing with it. I'll sit at work and I'll just go like this, like fuck with the back of my head. But if you can't get your hair cut shorter, or as short as this, do get it cut shorter, like shoulder length maybe shorter than that. Just not in a girl type fashion. A lot of guys do have longer hair, especially where I live. I live in a surfer city, and it's kind of the norm to have long hair. I mean, it's not the norm, but it's pretty popular. All right. Face shape. You really can't change your face shape. Apparently, I have a boyish face too. Guys' faces usually kind of angle and come to a point. Apparently, mine just does that because I pass quite often, even though sometimes I don't want to, and it makes me really awkward. Yeah. I don't know. Muscles. You have muscles, you usually can pass pretty well if you're wearing like a bro tank or something. Yeah, I just said bro tank, that's what I call them. Because generally guys are more muscular, they're more defined, so you know, stuff like whey protein and all those other vitamins and shit that I don't know about because I don't really care. I took whey protein like 5 times and then I wanted to puke because it tastes like burnt hair. Some people really like it. I had cookies and cream and it tasted like shit, and I will never have any ever again because it was fucking gross. But it works for a lot of people. You build muscle faster and you drop fat faster. So that's your thing. Go for it. Personally, I haven't worked out in like May, June, July, 2.5 months now. I haven't been able to work out since I left school, so I mean, I'm still. If I flex, I look okay. If I don't, I'm kind of not muscular at all. Yeah. Let's see. Okay, clothing, I guess. We'll talk about clothing. I'd show you my closet, but I don't want to go in my closet. It's that door right there, and I just don't want to get up. I'm sorry, I'm lazy. Just deal with it. You want to wear more masculine clothing, and if you're not allowed to buy slash wear masculine clothing, at least go for like unisex. Like, I wear band t-shirts, I'm pretty small chested, so like, you look at me straight on, you can't tell anything. This is also one of my favorite shirts. So, as far as pants go, I wouldn't go super skin tight if you're really trying to pass. I mean, guys wear skinny jeans, but girls also have hips. So, if you're trying to pass as a guy, I do not suggest super tight skinny jeans. If I wanted to show you my closet tonight, I'd show you the pair of pants that I always wore when I wanted to pass. I would sag them a bit because, you know, guys tend to sag their pants. And sagging gives the illusion that you don't have as big of hips, if you know what I mean. Yeah. What else? Some people like to give the illusion of having bigger feet. Because you know, guys have bigger feet, so what some people recommend is wearing bigger shoes and just stuffing the toes with something or stuffing the heels with something. I personally don't recommend that. That can really fuck you up. Don't do that. And then there's, of course, binding and packing. Binding is our topic next week, so I'm not going to talk a whole lot about it, but it's just the illusion of you not having a chest. It's a special compression top, stuff like that. Never, ever bind with ace bandages. You'll hear me say that a lot in my video next week. Just don't do it. It's so dangerous for your health, and it can also mess you up for getting top surgery, but we'll talk more about that next week. And hopefully my video will be on time next week. No promises, though. Packing is using a trigger warning flaccid penis to give the illusion of a bulge in your pants. And I'm not sure if that really triggers anyone, but I said the P word, and, you know, meh. Technicalities. I packed for, like, a day, and it just wasn't for me. Like, I don't need that ever. So I gave that away. I gave it to someone who I felt really needed it. I feel it was only like $12. It was worth it. I can put a link down there where I got it if anyone wants to know. I put it on one of my older videos. I think it was the binding and packing mash video. So if you want to go back and find that, you can. I got it on, where did I get it? Earlytobed.com. They're a really good site for any like packers, sex toys. I'm not into that kind of thing, so if that's your thing, go for it. It's not my thing. Some people also wear makeup. I know that sounds weird. They wear makeup, and it kind of contours their face. There's, like, what are they called? Tutorials all over the internet and Tumblr. You can find the one on Tumblr that goes around for FTMs and anyone who wants to appear more masculine for, like, cosplay and stuff. It's kind of like you accentuate your cheekbones or something like that. I don't know how it works. I'm not into makeup. I'm not into a whole lot of shit. So, if you want to search around and find that, I don't know the link to it. Someone else might. I don't know. There's also dropping your voice. That's one thing I forgot to talk about. You can lower your voice so you sound a little more manly. Like I'm doing right now, I probably sound really fucking awkward. But my normal voice is kind of in the middle. Like, I work where I have to call people a lot and answer phones a lot. So when I answer the phone, everyone's all, hello, ma'am, how are you? Because when I answer the phone, I answer it like this. I'm like, hi, how are you today? Like, super high pitch, because that's just what happens when I try to sound happy and friendly and shit. When I'm not in that kind of mood, I sound like this, like, naturally. Like, it's just a thing. I don't know. Again, there's tutorials all over YouTube and Tumblr for that if you look on the special FTM sites and the other collab channels. I know that was a lot of information crammed into 8 minutes, but yeah, sorry. That's all I got for you tonight, this week, whatever. I don't think I work next Sunday, so hopefully my video will go up on time. And that's all I got.